Students, today's topic is the polynomials. So already you know very well about the polynomial. Why we are using the polynomial representation here? Generally, you know, whatever the data we are entering into the computer, that can be shown as an 8-bit word or 16-bit word or 32-bit word or 64-bit word as per the configuration of the computer. Now that is called the n-bit word representation. Whatever we enter into the data, that will be converted into n-bit word format. N-bit means, n means it can be the 8 or 4, it can be an 8 or 16 or 32 or 64, whatever it may be. So the data can be shown as n-bit words in the computers. Those n-bit words can be easily represented by using the polynomials. What is the polynomial? Already you know about polynomial. How is the polynomial? Generally, a polynomial may contains the group of terms. The polynomial is nothing but the sum of the terms with some coefficients. So here, the n-bit words can be represented as polynomial. It is very easy to represent the n-bit words using the polynomial representation, using the polynomial format. So what is the polynomial? If you see the polynomial, what it contains? Generally, a polynomial has a degree. It has a degree from 0 to n minus 1. A polynomial has the degree from 0 to n minus 1, and it has the xi terms. What is the xi in the polynomial? Xi is nothing but the ith term. And what is the ai? Ai is nothing but the coefficient of the ith term. See this format. See this format here. This is the polynomial represented. For example, it is the general format of the polynomial. F of x is equal to some a n minus 1 into x power n minus 1 plus a n minus 2 into x power n minus 2 to a 1 x power 1 plus a 0 x power 0. So it is the 0, it's the x. This is the first term, second term, third term, up to n minus 1 terms. 0 to n minus 1 terms, n terms are there, where x power 0, it is the 0 term, 0 degree, it is the 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, up to n minus 1. Since there are n terms, the degree is 0 to n minus 1. And a0, this a0, a1, and an minus, these are called coefficients. Coefficients. For example, example for the polynomial is x power 4 plus x cube plus x. So here there is no x power 0 term, x power 1 term is here, x power 3 term is there, x power 4 term is there. So this is the one of the example of the polynomial. So here this type of representation, this type of polynomial representation is used to specify the n bit words in the computers. So here in the cryptography, our text, our messages are converted into n-bit words. The word size can be n-bit word, means the n value, n size, n can be the 8-bit word or 32-bit word, 16-bit word, 64-bit word. So we are using, generally, we are using 64-bit word size in the cryptography. So here, the n-bit words are, they can be easily represented, or the n-bit words can be shown as a polynomial in the cryptography. See this example. For example, here this figure shows how we can represent the 8-bit word. See this 8-bit word, 8 binary digits, 1001, 1001. This is the 8-bit word. Assume our text is converted into 8-bit words, and one of the 8-bit word is example. One of the 8-bit word is 1001, 1001. Now, how to show this 8-bit word? How to show this 8-bit word in polynomial representation? So, how to show this 8-bit word using the polynomials? So, see here. Here, what is the 8-bit word here? 1001. So this is the 8-bit binary digits. Now, polynomial, its polynomial representation is, the first one is here, come to the leftmost side. So this one is, assume these are the coefficients, 1001 coefficients, and its degree is, term degree is 0, its term degree is 1, its term degree is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And that means this 8-bit word has the terms are having the x power 0 degree to x power 7 degree, since the bit size, word size is 8-bit word size. Now, see this. This is the, its coefficient is 1. So, since, so 1 into x power 0, add for this 1 into x power 0. For this 0 is multiplied with x power 1. For this 0 is multiplied with x square. For this 1 into x cube. This 1 into x 4. This 0 into x 5. This 0 into x power 6. So, this one into x power 7. Now, x power 7 plus x power 4 plus x cube plus 1 is a polynomial. It is a polynomial. It is the equivalent representation for this. All the ones, so it contains all the terms. So this is represented, this 8-bit word is represented using this type of polynomial. Now, suppose if we have a polynomial, for example, x to the power of 5 plus x cube plus x. So now, find the 8-bit word for this polynomial. What is the 8-bit word for this polynomial where n is equal to 8? Its degree, total word size is 8-bit word. So, since it is the 8-bit word, We have the just note down the terminologies. So there is no x power 0 terminology here. So that's why it is 0 into x power 0 plus x power 1 terminology we have. So 1 into x power 1. And there is no x, there is no x, assume this is the x square, not cube, this is the x square. So since we have the x square, it is 1 into x square, there is no x cube, so it is 0 into x cube, there is no x to the power of 4, 0 into x power, there is x power 5, so 1 into x to the power of 5, there is no x power 6, there is no x power 7, that's why 0 into x power 6, 0 into x power 7. So the bit representation for this polynomial is just take all the coefficients of this polynomial. What are the coefficients? 0 first, this is the 0, this 0, this 1, next 0, next 0, 1, 1, 0. So this is the, by when we have a polynomial, we can convert that polynomial into the 8-bit word, or if we have the 8-bit word, that can be shown as a polynomial in the cryptography. This is very easy representation. Any n-bit words can be easily represented by using the polynomial, and a polynomial can be easily converted into the n-bit words. So this is the this is very easiest process. That's why we are using the polynomial representations for the n bit words in the cryptography. Generally, polynomial, in the case of the polynomial representation, for representing the n bit words, we use the two fields. One type of field is Galois field. 2, it can be used for coefficients, because see the coefficients of this, all the terms, the coefficient, all the coefficients, every coefficient, it can be either 0 or 1. It has either 0 or 1, only two digits. That's why all the coefficients are represented in GF2 format. And terms x power 0, x power 1, x square, x cube, these are represented by using GF 2 power n field format. So coefficients are using GF 2 field, terms are using GF of 2 power n field. So here, for representing the n bit words, we are using two types of fields, GF 2 for coefficients. GF 2 means that must use either 0 or 1 digit, because here all the coefficients are either 0 or 1, all the coefficients are represented by using the GF2 format. And terms x power 0, x square, x power 1, x cube, all are representing by using the GF2 power n term, GF2 power n field for the terms. Here, in the case of the polynomials, it is very easy to add the two polynomials. We can easily multiply the two polynomials, we can easily subtract the two polynomials, right? So the addition, subtraction, multiplication, all operations are easy in the polynomials. Suppose if we add the two polynomials, assume we have the two polynomials. If we add the two polynomial numbers, generally that never creates a polynomial out of the set. That means, suppose if we add the polynomials with the highest degree of x7, first polynomial has the highest degree x power 7, second polynomial also has the highest degree x power 7. If we add both these things, this can be, here x power 7 means its degree is not increasing. So, its degree is always x7 only. Maybe its coefficients may be changed. That's why if we add the two polynomials, its degree cannot be increased. Its degree cannot be increased. The polynomial is, it is not the out of the set. But if you multiply the two polynomials, may create a polynomial with degrees more than n minus 1. The degrees more than n minus 1. For example, if you multiply the terms with the x power 6 with x power 5, you multiply both these terms, the result is x power 11. That means the degree is increased. If you multiply the two polynomials, maybe the result polynomial can have the degree which is greater than n minus 1. Suppose if the degree is more than n minus 1, after the multiplication of two polynomials, you should reduce its result to its degree, whatever degree we have, we are maintaining. So the result which is increasing its degree after multiplication of the two polynomials, you should be reduce that result by using modulus operation, by using the modulus operation. So this means that we need to divide the result. Whenever the result after the multiplication has the degree more than n minus 1, you should divide the result by modulus, and keep only the remainder as the result. That is the final result. So suppose in the case of the modulo division, in the case of the modulus arithmetic, z equal, suppose if its modulus is 5, assume its modulus is 5. Now 5 into 5 is equal 25, but after modulo division it with 5, we got only the 0. 25 mod 5 is 0. So suppose if it is the 5 into 3, actually its answer is 15. It's a modulo division with it's not 5, assume it's 6 is the modulus. 6 is the modulus. It is the general arithmetic modulus. Suppose in the case of the Z6, that means modulus is 6. Now actually 3 into 4 is equal to how much? 12. 3 into 4 is equal to 12. But the Z6 should contain 0 to 5 only. 0 to 5. But we got 12 here. That's why to reduce this 12, you should modulo divide this 12 with this modulus 6. So 12 mod 6 is equal to 0. So this result all can be specified as 0 in Z6. Like that, in the case of the polynomials also, if we have the result after multiplication of two polynomials which is greater than the n minus 1 degree, you should divide that result by modulus and keep only the remainder. Here generally we are using a prime polynomial number as the modulus. So here we are using the a modulus can be a prime polynomial. So you should divide the result, whatever you get the some result after multiplying the two polynomials, assume you have some result. modulo divide this result with a prime polynomial, it's not, divide the result by normal polynomial. So if you get the exact result, if you want to get the final result, so the result should be divided by a prime polynomial number. Okay, what is the prime polynomial number? Generally, this prime polynomial number, with that you are going to divide the result, that is called irreducible polynomial. That means by using this prime polynomial, we are going to reduce the result within the degree of n minus 1. That's why this prime polynomial is also called as irreducible polynomial. So what is the prime polynomial generally? Actually, what is the prime number? For example, consider a prime number 7. Why it is called 7? Because this 7 cannot be factored. That means this 7, you cannot split this 7. It can be divided with either 1 or 7. That's it. It cannot be divided with any other number. For example, 6 is not a prime, because we can split this 6. You can rewrite this 6 as 2 factors. 2 into 3 is equal to 2 is one factor, 3 is another factor. So if any number has the factors, that is not a prime. If any number cannot be factored, that is called prime number. Here also, a prime polynomial means it is a polynomial that cannot be factored. That means if you have a polynomial that cannot be split, into subpolynomials. For example, you have a polynomial like this, x to the power of 4 plus x squared. This is not a prime polynomial, because you can rewrite this as x squared into x squared plus 1. So we have the two factors. X squared is one factor into x squared plus 1 is another factor. So this polynomial can be factored. That's why x to the power of 4 plus x squared is not a prime polynomial. It is not a irreducible polynomial. What is prime polynomial? What is the example for the prime polynomial? For example, you have a polynomial like this, x square plus x plus 1. X square plus x plus 1. This polynomial cannot be factored. Check. We cannot split this x square plus x plus 1. X square plus x plus 1. So it is the prime polynomial. See this another one. X plus 1. It cannot be factored. We cannot split this one. X, we cannot split this polynomial. So generally, prime polynomials are irreducible polynomials with a degree 1, or these two with a degree, that means x square. This is the one of the one for x cube, degree 3. These are the two irreducible polynomials. These 4 for 5, these are the irreducible polynomials. Irreducible polynomial means, or prime polynomial means, these are the polynomials. Those polynomials cannot be factored. See any polynomial, these polynomials cannot be factored. That means we cannot be split. For example, how we are getting these irreducible polynomials? For example, degree 1. What are the irreducible polynomials for degree 1? Degree 1 means, assume we have two terms, x power 1 and x power 0 terminology. Degree 1 means, assume we have x power 1 and x power 0. Okay. So degree one means this much is the one. But here this may be optional or may be there. So if it is optional, it is zero. If it is there, it is one. So 1 0 1 1. So since this is x power 1 into x power 1 is x power 1 means x plus 0. So this is the, this can be written as x plus 0 is equal to x. Now this can be written as x, this is the 1 into x plus 1 into x power 0 x plus 1. So for degree 1 we have the two polynomials x and x plus 1, and these two polynomials cannot be factored. That's why these, for degree 1, x plus 1 and x are both are the irreducible polynomials or prime polynomials. What about for degree 2? Degree 2 means we have the x square, assume we have x square, x power 1 and x power 0. So degree 2 means, so we should have the this degree. Since there are the three terms, assume it should be the one, but these two may be optional or may be there. Suppose if these two are optional, it can be the 0, 0, or it should be one, it should maybe, it can be the 0 and it may be the one, combination of these two digits, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. But all are the ones here. All are the ones here. So there are four combinations of polynomials with degree 2. What are those polynomials with degree 2? One is x square plus 0 into x power 1 plus 0 into x power 0. That means this is equal to x square, because we have the x square, but there is no x power 1, x square. So is it a prime polynomial? No, because x square can be written as x into x. So don't consider this combination. What is the another one? 1 0 1, that means x square is 1, x power 0 is 1. That means it can be written as x square plus, there is no x plus 1, x square, but this is 1. There is no x power 1. So x square plus 1. Actually, x square plus 1 also, we can factor this x square plus 1. How can we factor x square plus 1? X square plus 1 can be written as x plus 1 into x plus 1. If you multiply both the terms, what is the result? X plus 1 into x plus 1. First, multiply this one with this one. So, x square plus x plus with 1 multiply, after multiplying, we get the x plus 1. So, after x plus 1 into x plus 1, multiply x plus 1 with x plus 1, you got x square plus x plus x plus 1. In the case of the polynomials, one thing you should remember, the terms with the same degree, at the time of adding, the terms with the same degree, if you have, simply its result is 0. So these two terms can be 0. That's why, so x final answer is x square plus 1. That means x square plus 1 can have the factors like this. That's why this combination also not working. Similarly, this is also not working. But if you see this combination, x square plus x plus 1, this polynomial cannot be factored. That's why for degree 2, we have the only one irreducible polynomial or prime polynomial. Similarly, we have the two polynomials, two prime polynomials with degree 3. With degree 4, we have three polynomials, prime polynomials. With degree 5, we have the 5 prime polynomials. So we are using these polynomials at the time of multiplying the two polynomials for reducing the result. Why you are using the, mainly you should remember why you are using these type of irreducible polynomials or prime polynomials. Suppose if you multiply two polynomials, okay, the result, the degree of the result may be increasing, may be more than n minus 1. To reduce that result to n minus 1 degree, you should divide that result with some modulus. That modulus should be the, that value should be the a prime polynomial. So you should divide the result by a prime polynomial. What is a prime polynomial? A prime polynomial cannot be factored, just like a prime number. It cannot be factored. So we have different prime polynomials for degree 1, degree 2, degree 3. This table shows the prime polynomials are irreducible polynomials for degree 1, degree 2, degree 3, degree 4, and degree 5. This is about addition. What about addition? But for the addition, the result is not increasing its degree. That's why for addition, no need to divide the result by any prime polynomial. But at the time of multiplications, sometimes if the result, the degree of the result is increasing, it's n minus 1 degree, you should reduce the result by dividing it by a polynomial, prime polynomial. That is the prime polynomial. That is also called irreducible polynomial. Consider operations on the polynomial. So we can perform the addition operation. That means we can add the two polynomials. So here, you should remember, in the case of the polynomials, addition and subtraction operations on polynomials are same operations. Here, addition operation, there is no separate subtraction operation. Addition and subtraction operations are same operations. For example, in the case of the polynomials, x, if we add these two, the result is 0. Otherwise, x minus x, it's the result also. If you add these two, the result also 0. So in the case of the polynomial addition, in the case of the polynomials, addition and subtractions are both are same. In the case of the addition operation for polynomials with the coefficient in GF2 is add the coefficient. How to add the two polynomials? How to add two polynomials? Simply in GF2 field format, simply you can add the coefficients. You can add the coefficients of the corresponding terms. That means you can add x power, the coefficient of x power 7 of one polynomial with the coefficient of x power 7 of another polynomial. Similarly, x power 6 with x power 6. X power 5 with, add the coefficients of x power 5 with x power 5 from two polynomials. So how to add the two polynomials? This is very easy. Simply add the coefficients of the corresponding terms. Adding of two polynomials of degree n minus 1. Suppose if you add the two polynomials of degree n minus 1, always create a polynomial with the degree n minus 1 only. If you add the polynomials, two polynomials with the degree n minus 1, you get the result always with the degree n minus 1. Suppose if you add the polynomials with the highest degree x power 7 from the two polynomials, you get the result with the highest degree of x power 7 only. That is the thing. So remaining terms may be any other things. This is one of the information. So adding two polynomials of degree n minus 1 always create a polynomial with degree n minus 1 only. That means we do not need to reduce the result using the modulus, using the result. But in the case of the multiplication, we need to reduce the result using the modulus. Okay, this is the addition operation. So what is the main important thing in the addition operation? Polynomials, the addition and the subtraction operations are same on polynomials. Addition and subtractions are same on the polynomials. You should remember. And what is the additive identity in the case of polynomial? Additive identity means if you add something to a polynomial, you should get the same polynomial. How to get this one? This is very simple. The additive identity in a polynomial is a zero polynomial. Zero polynomial. What is the zero polynomial? A polynomial with all coefficients set to zero. A polynomial with the all the coefficients zero is called as the zero polynomial. That means if you add any polynomial with the zero polynomial, you get the same polynomial. That's why the zero polynomial is the additive identity. And what is the additive inverse? What is the additive inverse? Here, the additive inverse means if you add a number with its inverse number, you should get the zero. That is called additive inverse. So here, what is the additive inverse polynomial? If you have a polynomial, what is its additive inverse polynomial? Generally, in the case of the polynomials, if you have a polynomial, its additive inverse is also same polynomial. Same polynomial. Okay, because if you add these two polynomials, you will get the zero. As example, consider this example. Suppose if you have the polynomials like this, x to the x power 6 plus x square. Okay, assume it is one polynomial. I can say its inverse polynomial is also same polynomial, same x power 6 plus x square. Because if you add these two things, x power 6, x power 6, if the both the terms are same, it becomes 0. It also x square, x square, it is also 0. So we got the null here. So for any polynomial, its additive inverse is the same polynomial. Its additive inverse is the same polynomial. Example here, the adding of the two polynomials, the symbol is represented this symbol. Assume this plus, if this circle is called addition of two polynomials. Generally, the addition of two polynomials can be similar to the exclusive or operation. So here, example, add x power 5 plus x square plus x is one polynomial, x cube plus x square plus 1 is another polynomial. Assume this is one 8-bit word, this is another 8-bit word in g of 2 power 8, that means 8-bit word. This symbol shows the polynomial addition. Now, add these two polynomials, so what is the first polynomial? x power 5 plus x square plus x. Since it is the 8-bit word, we have the polynomial up to the x power 7 degree. That's why first represent or rewrite this given first polynomial with all the coefficients. With all the coefficients from 0 degree to 0 7, degree 7, degree 0 to degree 7. So first thing is x power 0 degree, 0 degree. For x power 0 degree, there is no x power 0 degree. There is no x power 0 term in the given polynomial. That's why it is 0 into x power 0. we have the x power 1 term, that's why 1 into x power 1. We have x square, that's why 1 into x square. We don't have, here there is no x cube term, that's why 0 into x cube. Here there is no x to the power of, so that's why 0 into x power 4. There is x power 5, that's why it is 1 into x power 5. There is no x power 0, x power 6 and x power 7, that's why this is 0 into x power 6, 0 into x power. This is the representation of the first polynomial. And what is the expansion of the second polynomial? So it is 1, that means x power 0 terminology is 1 into x power 0. There is no x power 1 term, that's why 0 into x power 1. So we have x square term, that's why 1 into x square. We have x cube term. We don't have any x power 4, x power 5, x power 7. That's why all are the 0 columns. This is the second polynomial represented. This is the first polynomial. This is the second polynomial. Now, add these two things. Add these two things. So, you can perform the exclusive OR operation on the coefficients. So what is the exclusive OR operation on the two bits? If the two bits are the same, that means 0, 0 or 1, 1, you get the 0 result. If the two bits are different, you get the 1. So, here, the first, consider the first term. Add first term. 0 into x power 0, 1 into x power 0. That's why answer is 1 into x power 0. Because here it is 0, it is 1. 0, since 0 and 1, different term is. So, its coefficient is 1, x power 0. It is also 1, 0. That's why it is 1x power 1. It is 1x square, 1x square. That's why its value is, since both are 1s, it is 0x square. It is 0 and 1, 0, 1, different bits. That's why 1x cube. 0x to the power of 4, 0x to the power of 4. So, 0x power. 0, 0. Both are same. 1, 0. So, different bits. That's why 1x to the power of 0 x cube x 6 0 x power 6 0. It is also 0 0. That's why finally we have the answer x 1 into x power 5 and x power 5 x power plus x cube plus x power 1 plus 1. This is the final result. So here you should remember one thing here. You should remember one thing here. Just simply, you should, at the time of adding the two polynomials, simply keep the uncommon terms. Keep the uncommon terms and delete the common terms. Keep the uncommon terms means in the first polynomial, one term is there, in the next polynomial, zero term is there. Both are different. The both coefficients are different, then keep that term. The both coefficients are same, simply delete that one. This is the exclusive OR operation. So, this is example for adding the two polynomials. Now, multiplication. How to multiply the two polynomials. So, in the case of the multiplication, generally, the case of the multiplication, at the time of multiplying the two polynomials is the sum of the multiplication of each term of the sum of the multiplication of each term of the first term, first polynomial, with each term of the second polynomial. That means you can multiply the each term of the first polynomial with each term of the second polynomial and add those results. That is the multiplication of two polynomials. What is the multiplication of two polynomials? So, multiply each term of the first polynomial with each term of the second polynomial and add all the terms. That is the multiplication. But the multiplication may create may create terms with degree more than n minus 1. The result can have more than n minus 1 degree. That means we need to reduce the result by using the modulus polynomial. That means you should divide the result. You should divide the result. The result contains greater than its degree. Greater than its degree, n minus 1. Then divide that one with some prime polynomial or irreducible prime polynomial for reducing the result. For reducing the result, you should do that one. Example. Consider this example. Multiply x power 5 plus x square plus x is one polynomial. X power 7 plus x to the power of 4 plus x cube plus x square plus x is another polynomial. In g of 2 power 8 means this is the 8-bit word. This is one of the 8-bit word. This is another 8-bit word. That means we should use the 8-bit word representation. So to multiply these two polynomials, with irreducible polynomial x power 8 plus x to the power of 4 x cube plus x plus 1. So this is the irreducible polynomial for reducing the result. After multiplying these two polynomials, you should divide the result with this modulus. Okay, first multiply these two terms. P1, assume first one is the P1, second one is the P2, polynomial 2. What is the first term of the first polynomial? X to the power of 5. So multiply the entire second polynomial with the x power 5. Plus multiply the second polynomial with the x square into x cube, x power 7 plus this. Then multiply, take the third term in the first of the first polynomial, and it is the this one, second polynomial. So first term x to the power of 5, this is x to the power of 5 into first polynomial, second polynomial. X square into entire second polynomial, third term of first polynomial, x into second polynomial. So multiply each one. How to multiply? For example, the case of the multiplication, x to the power of 5 into x to the power of 7. Here, add the degree. So x to the power of 5 into x power of 7 means it is x power 12, 5 plus 7, 12. And x to the power of 5 into x to the power of 4 means x power 9. X to the power of 5 into x cube means x power 8. It is x power 7, x power 6. Like that, x square into x power 7 into x power 9, the x power 6, like that. X into x square means x cube 8, x to the power of 5. X into x to the power of cube, x to the power of 4, like that. So now we have these terminals. After getting these terminologies, how we are adding these two terms, all the terms, if we have the two terms with the same coefficients, with the same degree, then cancel those one. So here we have x power 9. Here also we have x power 9. So simply remove that one. Here we have x power 8. Here also we have x power 8. Similarly, x power 7, there is no x power 7, but x power 6, there is no x power 6. Yes, we have 2 x power 6. Cancel that one. X power 5, here x power 5. X power 4, x power 4. X cube. Is there any x square? There is no x square. So finally, we got this x power 12 plus this x power 7 plus x square. So the degree of the result is x to the power of 12. Since it is the g of 2 power 8, 8-bit word size, the power value, degree value should be less than 8. So to reduce this x power 12 result, you should divide this result by the given irreducible polynomial, this one. After dividing the result with this modulus, you got this x power 5, x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. This is the final result of after multiplying these two polynomials. How to divide? How to divide the result? So, how to divide x to the x power 12 plus x power 7 plus x square? This can be divided. I am trying to divide this by this irreducible polynomial. Here x to the power of 12 is here. Here x power 8. So how many times it is? And so here x power 8 means if you multiply this one with the x to the power of 4, you will get the x this entire polynomial with the x to the power of 4. So what is the answer? Multiply this one with x to the power of 4, you get the answer x power 12. That means this 4 plus 8 plus x power 8, then x power 7, x power 5, x power 4. So multiply this one with, that means this polynomial into x power 4 times is equal to this one. So divide, subtract this one. X is subtraction or addition are both are same. So x power 12, x power 12, both are cancelled. So we have x power 8 plus x 7. Here x 7 is there, x 7 is there, both are cancelled. And x power 5, x to the power of 4, x square. Now, here, how many times this is dividing this one? This one into one time. So same thing. If you subtract this one with this one, both are cancelled, then x power 5 is here, x power 4 cancelled, x cube here, x square plus x plus 1. So this is the final result after multiplying these two. Actually, we got the x power 12 plus x power 7 plus x square. After modulo dividing this result with this one, we got this result. Okay. Next, we have the simple, how the computer performs this multiplication. We have that one that can be explained. The same multiplications can be explained using some algorithm. Here, what is the multiplicative identity? What is the multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative identity means, what is the meaning of the additive identity? The additive identity is zero polynomial. Here, multiplicative identity means with this multiplicative identity, if you multiply this with this, you should get the same polynomial. So, multiplicative identity in the GF2 power 8 is this one, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0 into 1. Because if you multiply any polynomial with this one, you get the same polynomial. What is the multiplicative inverse? Here, multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse can be calculated using the Euclidean algorithm as similar in the case of the normal modulus arithmetic. So, how we are getting the multiplicative inverse in modulus residue set? So, by using extended Euclidean algorithm, we will calculate the multiplicative inverse of the polynomial. Here also, similarly, you will get the multiplicative inverse. We can calculate multiplicative inverse using the extended Euclidean algorithm. This can be explained in the next class. What are the multiplicative identity and multiplicative inverses for the polynomials? Multiplicative identity means with that multiplicative identity, if you multiply with any polynomial, you should get the same polynomial. So here the multiplicative polynomial, the multiplicative identity in GF 2 power 8, that means bit 8-bit word field is 00001. Okay. This is the multiplicative identity polynomial. 0001 is the multiplicative identity polynomial. If you multiply any polynomial with this one, multiply any polynomial with this one, you will get the same polynomial. What is the multiplicative inverse? It is a polynomial. If you multiply the any polynomial with the multiplicative inverse, you should get zero. You should get the zero. That means this process is exactly same as for the integers. For example, 3 into its multiplicative inverse 1 by 3 is equal to 1. Similarly, if you multiply any polynomial with its multiplicative inverse, you should get the 1. Okay. To calculate the multiplicative inverse of the polynomial, we are using extended Euclidean algorithm. Get the multiplicative inverse of a polynomial using extended Euclidean algorithm. This is similar to the process of integers. You see this one. Find multiplicative inverse of x square plus 1. Assume x square plus 1 is a polynomial with the modulo x to the power of 4 plus x plus 1. So find multiplicative inverse for this polynomial x square plus 1, which is modulo with the x to the power of 4 plus x plus 1. So to get the multiplicative inverse, assume x to the power of, you should find out the GCD. X to the power of 4 plus x is, can assume is the R1. This x square plus 1 is R2. So this x square plus 1 into multiplies x square plus 1. You will get remainder x. After multiplying this with this, you will get the remainder x. Initial t1 is 0, initial t2 is 1. Here t equal to T1 minus, T means 0 minus Q into T2. Since T2 is 1, so this is x square plus 1. Negative or positive, in the case of the polynomials, all the negative or positive numbers are positive only. So x square plus 1. Now, this becomes R1. This x becomes R2. So this x, how many times divides this one? X times. So x into x, x square. After that, what is the remainder? Plus 1. Now this one is the t1. This is the t2. After my performing t1 minus this q into t2, the answer is x cube plus x plus 1. Now third row, this x becomes this new r1. This one becomes new r2. 1 x times divides the x, that's why remainder is 0. Then this x2 becomes t1, this x cube plus x becomes t2. So if you multiply, if you calculate the t equation, that is t1 minus this q into t2, will get the 0. You get the 0 here. Now, finally, this one is here, this remainder is here. So, GCD of this one is 1, and its multiplicative inverse is this one. So, the multiplicative inverse for x square plus 1 is x cube plus x plus 1. We can check this result is this multiplicative inverse is correct or not by multiplying this multiplicative inverse with x square plus 1. If you multiply x square plus 1 with x cube with this multiplicative inverse x cube plus x plus 1 with the modulo x to the power of 4 plus x is equal to 1. So you can check this one. X square into this one, x square into this one, x square into this one. So this is the x square into x5 means x to the power of 5 plus x cube plus x square. Then multiply the entire thing with 1. You will get x cube plus x plus 1. So after getting, after subtracting these one, finally you get x to the power of 5 plus x square plus x plus 1. If you modulo divide this with this one, you will get the 1 here. And final answer is 1. So how to get the multiplicative inverse for the polynomial using extended Euclidean algorithm. So this one is treated as R1. This one is treated as R2. X square plus 1. How many times this is dividing this one? X square plus 1 times. After that, you will get the X remainder. Then initial is 0. It is 1. What is the formula for T? T is equal to T1 minus Q T2. So this is the T value. In the next row, this becomes here. So x times this divides, 1 is remainder. Like that, finally we are getting this one. So this is the multiplicative inverse for that x squared plus 1. If you multiply this one with this one, you will get the, after modulo division, you will get the 1. Now, this multiplication of two polynomials can be done by the computer. How the computer performs the multiplication of the two polynomials? Generally, multiplying of two polynomials need the division operation for reducing the result. If you use the division operation for reducing the result, that decreases in efficiency. That's why computer uses an algorithm for multiplication of polynomials that should not use the division operation. The computer should not use the division operation for multiplying the polynomials. Instead of division operation, repeatedly multiplying a reduced polynomial by x. For example, instead of finding the result of x square into p2, p2 is another polynomial. So x square into p2, it can be done like this. X square can be done x into p2. So this is the x into x. This is the previous result. If you multiply this with x, you will get the x square into x. For example, one more example is, if you wanted to multiply x to the power of 5 into p2, this is equal to x into, its previous result is x to the power of 4 into x to the power of 4 into p2. So recursively you are multiplying the results without to performing the division operation. That's why computer multiplies the two polynomials without using the division operation. We can check this one. Consider p1 equal to x to the power of 5 x square plus x. P2 is x power 7 x to the power of 4 x cube x square plus x. in GF 2 power 8, that means 8 bit word size, with the residual polynomial x power 8, x to the power 4, x power. For this one, assume these are the powers, this is the operation, what is the result, what is the reduction. Now, multiply this P2 in each and every step, multiply the P2 with at first time x power 0, then x power 1, multiply P2 with x power 1, P2 with x square, P2 with x cube, P2 with x to the power of 4, P2 with x to the power of 5. Multiply till x to the power of 5. 0, x power 0 to x power 5. Since it is x to the power of 5. So multiply, even though it has the x power 1, x square, x5 only, but you should multiply the P2 with the x power 0 in the first case. Multiply P2 with x power 1, x square, like that. Now, in the first step, multiply the P2 with the x power 0. X power 0 means 1. So 1 into P2 means the same result. X power 7, x power, x cube, x square plus x. There is no reduction. No need to reduce the result because it's x power 7. It is less than the 8. Less than 8. Now, multiply the P2 with the x1. How it to performs? Now, already the x1 into P2 means x power 1 into P2 means this is equal to x into P2. So what is the previous value? This is the previous result. So P2, so this is x. So x into x power 7 means actually we are getting x power x into x power 7 means x power 8, x power 5, x to the power 4, x cube plus x square. But after reducing the result with x power 8, x power 4, x cube plus 1, the result is this one. So here we are using the reduction. Then x square plus p2 can be written as x square. The previous result is x power 1 into p2 into x. So it is x power 6 like this. X cube into P2 means x into this result, x into this one. So we get this one. X to the power of 4 P2 means x into this one. So here also, x into x to the power of 7 means x power 8. X power 8 means it exceeds the n value, n minus 1. That's why reduce, divide the result with the x power 8, this one. After dividing this one, we get this one. Here we reduced the result. Then x power 5 into P2 means x into this one. So answer is x to the power of 4 plus x square plus x1. Now, how many terms in P1? X power 5, x square, x. That means you have to add this result, x power 5 result, then x square result, then this x result. After adding all these, you get this final result. Now, this can be done by the computer by using some algorithm. If you observe the algorithm, if the most significant bit, in the result or previous result is zero, suppose in the first step, we have a result. In that result, the most significant, if that most significant bit of the result is zero, just shift the previous result one bit to the left. Shift the previous result one bit to the left. That is first step. That is one case. If the most significant bit of the previous result is one, the most significant bit of the previous result is one. Previous it is one. For that purpose, done two things. Shift it one bit to the left and exclusive R it with the modulus. Exclusive R with the modulus. So here two cases. If the most significant bit of the previous result is one, simply left shift one bit. Otherwise, if the most significant PS, most significant bit of the PS result is 1, first shift to the 1 bit left, then exclusive OR that one with the modulus. Okay, see the, suppose, if you consider the previous one, x power 0 into P2, what is the x power 0 into P2? The previous example. X power 0 into P2 is x power 7, x to the power of 4, x cube, this one. So, the bit representation of this one is x power 7 is there. That means 1. X power 6 is not there. X power 5 is not there. So, 0, 0. So, 1, 0, 0. Its value is 1, 0, 0. X power is there. X cube is there, x square is there, x is there, but there is no x power 0. That's why. So its value is 1001, 1110. So this is the binary representation of the P2. X power 0 into P2 is P2. The binary representation of P2 is this one. Now, check the most significant bit in this result. What is most significant bit? It is the 1. Since it is the 1, left shift this one, 1 bit left side. Left shift the all the bits to shift the all the bits 1 bit left side. That means this one come out. Now this come to here. Every bit is shifted left 1 bit. So after that, this is the answer. Now exclusive OR this with the modulus. So exclusive OR this with the modulus. Exclusive OR means if the both bits are same, the both bits are same, then you will get the 0. So both the bits are different, you will get the 1. So this is at 0, 0, the first one is 0, 0. That's why this is the 0, not 1, this is the 0. Second bits are 0, 1, so its answer is 1. Third bits are 1, 0, so its answer is 1. Then 1, 1, so 0, like that. If the both bits are same, here answer is 0. If both bits are different, here answer is 1. That's why we get this result. Now, x square into P2 means check the most significant bit 0. So, most significant bit 0 means it is 0. So, simply left shift 1 bit. 1 bit left, after left shift 1 bit, this is the answer. This is the answer. Here also most significant bit is 0. That's why left shift all the bits, left shift all the bits, one position. This is the answer. Then, here the most significant bit is 1. That means left shift all the bits, one position. Then this is the answer. Exclusive OR this with the modulus. Then finally you are getting this one. Now most significant bit is 0. That means in the next step, left shift all the bits one position left side. This is the answer. So finally, what are P1 into P2 means? What are the x to the power of 5? Then x square, then x1. This is the answer. This is the answer. Now, addition table for GF 2 power 3, that means bit size is 3. If the word bit size is 3, 3 combination means 000, 001, 010, 011, 10010. These are the 9 different words using the 3 bits. These are also same. If we add these things, this is the addition table. For example, consider anyone. Addition of 1000 with this one. Addition of 1000 with 010. So at the time of addition, 00 means 0, 01 means 1, 10 means 1. If the both bits are different, put 1. If the both bits are same, put 0. So answer is 110. Similarly, one more example is, this is the multiplication table for GF 2 power 3. Multiplication table. Assume here irreducible polynomial is x cube plus x square plus 1. When we are using this one, suppose if you multiply any two numbers with this one and this one, if that result, the degree of that result exceeds 3 minus 1, then you should divide that result with this polynomial. For that purpose, we are using that irreducible polynomial. Now, this is the irreducible one. Multiply. So, since it is 2 cube, that means with 3 bits, we will have the 9 combination of bits, elements. Row wise and column wise, take these values. If you multiply this 000 with this 0, all the 000 with all these one, you are getting this one. Multiply 001 with all these one, same values. Multiply this one with all these values, you will get these values. For example, x into x square plus 1. Otherwise, this one, x into x square plus x. So, x into x square plus x. Actually, what is the answer? X into x square plus x means x cube plus x square. So it exceeds the degree 2. Since it is 2 power 3, 2 power 3 means 3 bits. 3 bits means so its degree should be maximum degree is 2 only. But in answer, we get the x cube. That's why divide this one with irreducible matrix. X cube plus x square plus 1. So this one 1 times. So this one 1 times this one. So after subtracting this one, this will be gone. What is the final answer? So 1. So this is the answer. 1. Like that, we will get the all the values for GF 2 power 3. For GF 2 power 3.